What, where, how and when? What is history? The story of humankind's past is called history. History tells about various developments which have taken place in the human society in different periods of time. What is the importance of history? History helps us in knowing about the past kings, kingdoms and the society. History tells us about the way people lived, the food they ate and the clothes they wore. History tells us about the occupations of the people. History tells us about the great achievements of our ancestors. History tells us about the mistake made by our ancestors. History also tells about the games played during a particular time. We learn from history to make a better future. History, proto-history and prehistory. Historians have classified the past into history, proto-history and prehistory. History of man started when man learned how to write. They began to keep records of the times. This period is known as history. Proto-history is the time period for which we have written records, but they are few and still cannot be read. The time before man began writing is called prehistoric era. Prehistory is the period where humans lived in India. Many geographical locations in India were inhabited by the early settlers. Women began settlements near rivers. This gave them access to water. Historians have identified many such sites. The banks of the river Narmada were inhabited by humans thousands of years ago. They were hunter-gatherers. They were hunted wild animals for food. Also, they gathered fruits, leaves and seeds or dug up roots of plants for their food. The Kirthar and Suleiman Hills are the areas where humans first began growing crops about 8,000 years ago. They grew wheat and barley and also began domesticating animals. The Vindhyas in the central region close to the Narmada River and the Garo Hills in the northeast show evidence of the development of agriculture. It is here that rice was first cultivated. Humans also lived near the river Indus and its tributaries. In fact, it is here that the first cities came up about 4,700 years ago. There is evidence that cities were established near the river Ganga and its tributaries about 2,500 years ago. Even large kingdoms came up near the rivers. Magadha was one such large kingdom which grew near the river Sun, which is a tributary of river Ganga. The name of our country. India is known by many names like Aryavarta, Jambudvip, Bharatvarsh, Bharat, Hindustan, India. Out of them, India, Hindustan and Bharat are more frequently used. How the name India came into existence? The people from Iran and Greece came to northwest of India. Thus, they became familiar with the river Indus. They call it Indos or Hindos. The land to the east of this river came to be known as India. Bharat. People who lived in the northwest were known as Bharata. They are mentioned in the Rig Veda. The name Bharat came because of the term Bharata. What are the different sources of history? Some of the sources which tell us about the history are as follows. Manuscripts, inscriptions, coins, archaeological sites. Manuscripts. A handwritten book is called manuscript. Before the discovery of printing, books were handwritten. The early manuscripts were written on palm leaves and on bark of birch trees. The ancient manuscript gave a lot of information about religious beliefs and practices, life of kings, medicine, science, poem, plays and epics, etc. Inscriptions. The text written on stone slabs is called inscription. An inscription on stone could survive longer than a manuscript. Most of the inscription contains some order or announcement by a king. Such announcements were written in inscriptions so that a large number of people could read them. Some inscriptions contain good deeds by people, especially by kings and merchants. The inscriptions and manuscripts from ancient period were usually written in Sanskrit or Prakrit or Tamil. Coins. A coin gives information about the king of the period because coins usually contain the image of the king. Coins also tell us about the level of skill among artisans during that period. Coins were first developed in ancient Greece during 600 BC. Archaeological sites. Sites from where historical remains are obtained are called archaeological sites. Buildings and monuments also come under archaeological sites. Archaeological sites also include old buildings and monuments. Artifacts and other items excavated from different archaeological sites gave rich information about a period. What are the meaning of dates in history? Dates are very important while studying history because dates help in arranging the events in some sequence. While discussing history, two distinct terms are usually heard, BC and AD. The term BC stands for before Christ. On the other hand, AD stands for Anno Domini, which means in the year of the Lord. Sometimes C is used instead of AD and it means common era. Similarly, BC is used instead of BC and it means before the common era.